investment in knowledge pays the best interest. Every once in a while, a great personality is born with whom comes a vision that transcended generations. A man who said education has always helped mankind and it is our duty to continue this legacy. The iconic Professor Lalit Kumar Awasthi, the director of NIT Jalandhar, is a persona of unique insight and multiple genius. His firm vision of imparting quality education that would mold the frame of mind and ethical fiber of the students. The institute has total 15 multidiscipline departments in which physics department stands out for its research and academic activities. The walk started as a tiny department in the year 1989 but is now providing a cutting-edge research and quality education to their students. The department offers undergraduate program in BTech, the postgraduate program in MSc Physics and full-time and part-time PhD program in various theoretical and experimental fields. The students of the department are imparted knowledge in the various fields of physics, made trained in basic and advanced skills. A high-spirited team of well-qualified and learned faculty, skilled and experienced technical staff, amiable administrative staff, an inquisitive and eager group of research scholars is the strength of our department. The department strives to emerge as a premier center of physics education and research across the country. Our research is organized within the general areas such as theoretical research in plasma physics, nuclear physics, high energy physics, and condensed matter physics. Also, on the experimental side, in liquid crystals, radiation physics, high energy physics, and condensed matter physics. The modern and leading-edge infrastructure available for students and researchers include smart classrooms, computer facility, and high-end technical laboratories for gaining the experimental knowledge. The department is always in the forefront in research activities in terms of peer-reviewed publications, conducting national and international conferences, workshops, symposia, and lecture series in which students participate with a great enthusiasm and develop a research aspiration among themselves. The department has its own dynamic website and is also very active on every popular social media platform.
The Department of Physics was established in 1989 and is running undergraduate programs where the Department of Physics is participating in offering a full semester theory and practical course on physics for all the branches. Material science is offered for chemical engineering, EC and IC branches. In addition to this, department is also offering open elective courses on material science and computational and statistical techniques for 6th, 7th and 8th semester of all the branches. The department is also running a full-time postgraduate program, MSc in Physics, and the present intake is around 40. Full-time and part-time PhD program in Physics was started in 2006 and about 25 students have been awarded PhD degree. And at present, around 40 students are registered for the PhD program. The department hosts two classrooms for postgraduate students with smart boards. There is a conference room with the facility to host around 40 people. The department is committed towards high quality teaching and pursuit of excellence in research. We pledge to serve the nation and society by providing skilled and well-developed human resources through brilliance in technical education and research. We also inculcate moral and ethical values with a sense of competitiveness, self-confidence, and sincerity among the students to make them a good human and a good citizen. At present, we have 12 faculty members. The faculty of Department of Physics is actively participating in diverse fields of research in physical sciences. The broad areas of research are theoretical plasma physics, experimental and theoretical nuclear physics, radiation physics, experimental and theoretical condensed matter physics, experimental and theoretical high energy physics, and liquid crystals. The department, since its inception, has to its credit more than 400 research publications and has conducted more than 30 workshops, conferences, and short-term courses. More than 20 research projects with external funding amounting to about 4 crore have been received by the department so far.
Field of research is laser plasma interactions. As we all know that nuclear fusion is considered to be an ultimate source of energy for future electrical power plants and offers a significant potential advantage as compared to fission. Abundant fuel available to all nations, environmentally benign, safe and without atmospheric pollutants or long-term radioactive waste. There are two approaches to fusion. The one is industrial confinement fusion and the second is magnetic confinement fusion. Worldwide research is going on for the successful operation of these two approaches. My research is focused on inertial confinement fusion, in which the high power laser beam rapidly heats the upper surface of the target, fusion target, that is the ATT pellet, and thus forms a surrounding plasma envelope, or you can say form a plasma layer. As the laser beam propagates through this plasma surrounding plasma envelope, many nonlinear phenomena come into picture, which basically prohibits the transfer of the energy from the laser beam to the plasma and therefore play a major role for the successful operation of inertial confinement fusion. We theoretically study self-focusing harmonic generation stimulated Raman scattering stimulated brilliant scattering of laser beam in laser produced plasma. Moment theory is being used to investigate these nonlinear phenomena, in which the entire laser profile is being used to investigate this nonlinear phenomenon. I am also doing a research on electron acceleration and terahertz radiations, which have significant technological advantages.
Myself, Dr. Rohit Mehra, presently working as an associate professor in the Department of Physics. I am having an experience of around 23 years of teaching and research, and my area of specialization is radiation physics and experimental nuclear physics. At present, I am also heading the lab of radiation monitoring and assessment lab in our department, which has been established in collaboration with the BRC Mumbai, where we have all the state-of-art equipments for the environmental monitoring of the natural radiations. Apart from our routine activities of teaching, we are actively involved in the research, where we have our group has nearly completed 14 PhD students which have done PhD under my supervision, and 6 are still pursuing their PhD. And apart from this, 10 MPhil students I have guided, and nearly 40 PGE dissertations I have supervised. So this was something about my academics, and I'm presently teaching the different subjects of radiation monitoring, nuclear instrumentations to the PG students, as well as the BTEC courses of applied physics to the undergraduate students. I have published nearly 150 SCI publications in international journals, and my collaborations involves various institutes, which includes Baba Atomic Research Center, Mumbai, EMD, Atomic and Mineral Divisions, Government of India, and NIRS, Japan, that is National Institute of Radiological Sciences, Hirosaki University. I'm a visiting fellow to the NIRS Japan also, and also visiting fellow for the Nuclear Environmental Group of Government of Egypt. Apart from this, I have received a G.R. Udas and K.K. Dwivedi medal for my contributions to the field of applied geochemistry from the Indian Society of Applied Geochemists for my 10 years contribution in year 2018. So this was something related to my academic career, and I have established a very good lab with the help of funding agencies, which includes BRNS, DAE, Department of Atomic Energy, where I have completed nearly 3 projects which have been sponsored by Department of Atomic Energy for the environmental radiation monitoring assessments in different areas of Malwa region of Punjab, in Churu and other Sikar districts of Rajasthan, in some areas of Haryana. So this is something which I would like to share with all of you, and if you people are interested in pursuing some internship under our supervisions, our lab is very well equipped with the state-of-art facilities, and we welcome you all. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.
I have done my MSc and PhD from Punjab University, Chandigarh. I work in theoretical high energy physics, and I have around 4 PhD students working with me right now. 3 PhD students have already passed out, and we work in the area of understanding the structure of hadrons, in particularly the low energy regime, using the non-perturbative quark models. So this problem of understanding the structure of hadrons is the most challenging problems in the present day, and we plan to understand the structure and the dynamics inside the hadrons using the quark models.
Hello, myself Dr. Parveen Malik, and I am working as assistant professor in this Department of Physics and at Jalandhar. I did Masters from CCS University Meerut and MPhil from IIT Roorkee. After that, I joined PhD from Thapar Institute of Engineering and Technology and completed my PhD in 2005 in the area of liquid crystals materials. That was experimental work. Later on, I joined IIT Jalandhar as a faculty member, as assistant professor in 2007. I have a teaching experience of 15 years and research experience of 20 years at different capacity, like research fellow, senior research fellow, as well as other capacity. My research work is focused on experimental soft condensed matter, particularly experimental liquid crystal materials. Here we are working on liquid crystal materials and their composites, which are prepared by different materials like polymers, dye, nanomaterials, self-assembled blue film materials, and other kind of ferroelectric materials. We are characterizing these materials using different techniques. These are basically polarizing microscopy, dielectric spectroscopy, DSC, for flexible display, sensors, large-scale PDLC systems. So these are the major applications in which we are trying to study these materials. I have developed a liquid crystal research lab in the Department of Physics with all the major experimental facilities. In our group, presently 4 students are working for their PhD and 5 students have completed their PhD dissertation under my supervision. Nearly 35 students have also completed their master dissertation. I have received various awards like INSA Visiting Fellowship to work in nanomaterials at IIT Roorkee in 2012, DST Sarab Young Scientist Award in 2012, Young Achiever Award, DAE Symposium in 2013, and few papers were also selected as the best paper in the various national as well as international conferences. Regarding research contribution, I have published 75 research papers of high impact factors, mainly in SCI Index Journal, and filed a patent. I have received various R&D research projects from different funding agencies like DST, SERP-DST, and CSR of cost nearly 1.0 crores. We have a strong collaboration not only in India but in foreign countries also. And these collaborations are from Department of Dielectric Institute of Physics, Academy of Sciences of the Czech Republic, Prague. In India, we have a collaboration at Allahabad University, Allahabad. We have a collaboration at CSR lab, that is CSIO in Chandigarh, and some other Indian universities like DIT, CSIS University. I am also a member of international as well as the National Liquid Chemical Society and some other major societies of India. Those are related to the magnetic sense. Any person, any researcher, any faculty members, and research scholars who are interested to join our research group may visit and contact us at the link available at Physics website. Thank you. Namaskar.
Hello everyone. My name is Abhinav. I am assistant professor in physics department at NIT Jalandhar. I joined here in 2012. I did my PhD from IUAC, New Delhi, and did postdoc at Pohanga Accelerator Lab, in which where I was working on X-ray absorption spectroscopy and X-ray beam line. And since 2012, I am at NIT Jalandhar, and I am working in material science. During my PhD, I worked on diluted magnetic semiconductors. I have extensively used accelerators for my research. For example, I have used swift heavy ionic radiation, I have used low energy ionic radiation, and during postdoc and present day also, I am using synchrotron radiations for characterization of materials. I have worked on oxides. Some of my work is based on metals as well. Correlated electron material system is my main focus of study, and some of my PhD scholars presently are working on transparent conducting oxides. For example, Yogesh is working on that, and Neha Chauhan is working on that, and Neetu is another one of my other research scholar who is working on chalcogenide materials, where she is working on phase change materials and she is studying the effect of swift heavy ionic radiation on those materials. I am planning to extend my research to other correlated electron materials, and I want to move into the fields of topological insulators as well to see that what kind of future applications it can have.
I joined NIT Jalandhar in year 2012. I completed my PhD from the Department of Physics in IIT Delhi in year 2011 in theoretical high energy physics. After that, in October 2011, I joined here at Ahmedabad as postdoctoral fellow for 5 months, and then joined here in NITJ in 2012. My field of research is theoretical high energy physics. Specifically, we are working on non-perturbative design of the QCD. We are interested in understanding the medium modification of the hadrons at finite density and temperature. For example, we have explored the medium modification of kyons and antikyons, D mesons and Char module. Currently, we are also exploring the impact of finite magnetic field on the properties of these mesons. All these studies have the implications in heavy and collision experiments. Our group is also working on understanding the property of astrophysical compact objects, for example, neutron stars. Also, some of my students, they are working on use of the transport model and clubbing those with the chiral hadronic model, and that will also help us in comparing our research directly with the experimental observable. Further, I am working on a research project in which we will calculate the fluctuations and correlations, and that will help us in exploring the location of the critical endpoint in the QCD phase diagram.
Hello everyone, I am Dr. Kiran Singh, working in the Department of Physics, National Institute of Technology, Jalandhar. I have joined this institute in September 2018. Basically, I am working in the field of experimental condensed matter physics, and I have visited different countries like France, Germany, Netherlands, Italy, UK for different research purposes. I have completed my PhD in the field of superconductivity in December 2008. I have received Young Scientist Award in Physics from MPCST in year 2007. I have worked as a postdoctoral fellow for 3 years in CNRS Laboratory Bismet, France. There we were investigating the fascinating phenomena of multiferricity and magnetoelectric coupling in different materials. In March 2012, I have joined as a visiting fellow at Tata Institute of Fundamental Research, Mumbai in Professor Sampath Kumaran group. There we have developed the facility required for the measurement of multiferricity and magnetoelectric coupling. This facility is suitable to measure the multiferricity and magnetoelectric coupling for different materials like polycrystalline, thin film and single crystal at wide range of temperature and magnetic field. In November 2012, I have joined UGCDA Consortium for Scientific Research as a scientist, and I have contributed in different state-of-art research facilities. Low temperature and high magnetic field X-ray diffraction facility is one of them, and which is unique in the country. So here at NIT Jalandhar, we are developing the laboratory for multifunctional materials, multiferric and magnetoelectric materials, magnetic materials, ferroelectric and piezoelectric materials. We are also working on renewable energy materials. At present, we are having the basic synthesis facilities. We are also having the X-ray diffraction facility at our Institute Instrumentation Center. For other different measurements, we are utilizing the facility available with our collaborator at UGCDA Consortium for Scientific Research, Indore, Mumbai, Tata Institute of Fundamental Research, Mumbai, RIIT at Indore, other IITs and NITs. Apart from this, we are also utilizing the international beam lines like Petra, Germany, ICC's facility at UK, Auckland National Laboratory at US.
Hello, my name is Dr. Shesh Savrabari. Working as an assistant professor in the physics department, I have joined the department in 2018. I have completed my PhD from Indian Institute of Science Education and Research, Mohali. During my PhD, I have worked on cryo-free dilution refrigerator of base temperature 10 mK with 9 Tesla magnetic field. I gained the experience of setting up a clean room with advanced tool to develop nanoscale devices like SAM, lithography, plasma etching, etc. Presently, I am working in the field of quantum thermodynamics, specifically 2 and 3 level system to make the quantum heat engines. I am focusing on power and ecological functions. For this, our group is using density matrix formalism and quantum master equations.
Myself, Dr. Sunyatat, is working as assistant professor in the department since the year of 2018. I have completed my PhD from Department of Physics, Punjab University, Chandigarh. During my PhD, I had worked on the search for Higgs in association with Z boson at the D0 experiment in Fermi Lab, United States. During my PhD, I had also worked on the development of algorithm for B-quark identification. After the submission of my PhD, I joined Department of Physics, Purdue University, Indiana, United States as postdoctoral research associate. There, I worked on the muon identification at CMS detector, CERN, Geneva. In August 2013, I joined Department of Physics and Material Science, Shurini University as assistant professor. During my tenure at the university, we were successful in being the associate member of India CMS collaboration. In CMS, our group worked on the search for physics beyond standard model. in addition to this, our group also worked on the electromagnetic calorimeter component of the CMS detector. During this period, I have also successfully completed two externally funded research projects. The first one was funded by DST-SCRB and the another was jointly funded by DST and DA. At NIT Jalandhar, our group is working on two independent aspects of high energy physics. The first is the understanding of underlying event activity at the Hadron Collider. Underlying event activity involves multi-parton interactions, initial and final state radiations, pile-up, and beam-beam remnant, etc. All these aspects are quite important in the simulation of complete event activity at the collider experiment. Secondly, our group is working on the understanding of the impact of medium modification on the kyon and anti-kyon masses using AMPT model.
Myself, Dr. Vinod Shippen, faculty in the Department of Physics, NIT Jalandhar. I did my PhD from IIT Roorkee and postdoc from Texas A&M University, Punjab University, Chandigarh, and I was a visiting scientist at the University of Dumain, Le Mans, France. My broad area of research is theoretical condensed matter physics, and the current research interest of my group is to study the many-body correlation effects in quantum liquids, fermions, and bosons. We study the system theoretically as well as using quantum Monte Carlo simulation. In my lab of computational many-body physics, we will procure two workstations very soon to facilitate high-end computational facility for our research work. In my group, two JRF students are working on the recent research problems of Domenico-Ruttinger liquid and ground state properties of electron gas using variant random phase approximation. These systems of interacting particles have fascinating property and technological applications in nanoelectronics, biomedical applications, sensors, energy harvesting, and quantum information processing. Apart from the facility in the Department of Physics, presently I am having two sponsored research projects entitled Many-Body Correlation Effects in One-Dimensional Electronic Material, funded by SERB, DST, New Delhi, and the project entitled One-Dimensional Interacting Electron Fluid and the Formation of Electron Correlation, funded by DFG Germany. This project is funded for the initiation of international collaboration of India, UK and Germany. Thank you.
Welcome to Radiation Monitoring and Assessment Laboratory in Department of Physics at NIPG. This lab is equipped with the latest instruments in the field of radiation dosimetry and protection. It caters to radioactivity in all three environmental media, namely soil, water and air. Starting with the soil section, we have static radon and phoron monitor to estimate exhalation rates in soil and building materials. Next, we have sodium iodide scintillator detector. It measures concentration of radionuclides like radium, thorium and potassium in soil and building materials. Coming to the water section, we have double distillation unit with an output of 4 liters per hour. Next in line comes the major facility of our lab, the atomic absorption spectrophotometer. It can determine concentration of 16 heavy metal ions including arsenic, mercury, lead, etc. in aqueous samples like water, chemical solutions, wastewater, etc. We also have RAD-7, an active multipurpose detector to monitor radon, boron concentrations in soil, water and air. It can also determine radon and boron exhalation and emanation rates efficiently. Then we have highly efficient LED fluorimeter to measure concentration of uranium in water samples. Also, we have portable meters to determine physicochemical parameters like pH, TC, TDS, redox potential in water and soil samples. air section, the lab works in tune with Baba Atomic Research Center, Mumbai for various research projects. For passive dosimetry of radon, boron and their progeny in indoor dwellings, we have 100 plus pinhole cup dosimeters, deposition-based sensors and wire mesh DTPS-DRPS. Etching mark and spark counters are also present for complete analysis of LR115 films. Magnetic stutter, digital vein balance and optical microscope are other auxiliary instruments. Thus, the lab is one of the most advanced experimental labs in North India. We have time and again produced several international publications of repute. We are the first in the country to work for biokinetic modeling of uranium in humans. Thus, the lab is one of the most advanced experimental labs in North India. We have time and again produced several international publications of repute. And we are the first in the entire country to work for biokinetic modeling of uranium in humans.
So, this is the liquid crystal laboratory. This is the laboratory. This is basically dedicated to research work as well as here. We are also performing some experiments related to the MSc physics. So, it is the lab in the Department of Physics. So, first of all, I welcome. This laboratory, liquid crystal laboratory, and these are my research fellows. C. Jalandri, C. Jalandri, C. Smith Yadav, C. Jalandri, liquid crystal materials, and some other students also working here for their PhD. So, this is a little bit introduction about the experiments. You can see this is the Mohalik optical microscope of a Nikon make, and here, so this Nikon microscopy. Can basically tactile the materials. So tactile materials means here we are basically tactile the liquid crystal materials and different phase of the materials we are tactile generally. So what we do, we have a sample. Sumit, can you show the sample? We put our sample, that sample is basically placed between the two glass plates, and the sample will be like that, you can see from here. The sample will be sandwiched between the two glass substrates, that the ITO coated glass substrates which are highly transparent, and in between these two glass plates that material is filled, and finally we can see the different phases as well as the phase transition temperature of these materials that are already filled. That sample can be pulled between this hot stage, and here we can put this hot stage. And through the this microscopy, we can examine the different phases. This is the basically hot stage, that is connected to the temperature controller. And through this temperature controller, we can go from room temperature and below room temperature also with the help of this chamber, from minus 196 to maximum 600 degrees centigrade at a different rates, like 0.01 degrees centigrade and higher than this. So this is our requirement. And according to our requirement, we can change the rate of the this temperature. So this assembly is like that. The sample is placed in this hot state. We can control the temperature and we can identify the textures that can be interfaced to the system to this CCD camera. If we are talking about the electrical property, so we can calculate the electrical property by using the impedance analyzer, and that impedance analyzer we can go from 20 Hz to 10 MHz, and this model is Binaker, that is a very precision impedance analyzer, 6.00 dB. So here we can use this sample, and we can collect it here and we can take it. Here you can see one of the sample is going on through the heating treatment, and Sumit is working on this particular sample, and here you can see that there is some transitions are going on. The state of the material is going to change. Okay, so this is the little bit information of the temperature controller as well as following microscopy. On this side, this is the UVBIS spectrophotometer. So this we can calculate the band gap of these materials, and we can put our sample here. So
samples between the sample holder, and we can calculate the required parameters.
On this side, this is the differential scanning calorimetry. Recently we got it from the under a project that the DSC 8000, that is of May Perkinelmo. And through this equipment, we can basically calculate the failed conditions of the materials. So not only liquid crystals, but some other kind of the materials like polymers are also can be studied in the geometry. So this is the complete assembly through this gas and this pressure here, and we can calculate the failed transition. Basically, we can calculate the failed transition not only by DSC, but through the polarized microscopy also. So you can see these small grids that are to heat up the samples. This is the microbalance of a very high precision microbalance. This is the small unit again for a this is local wet screen coating unit. Just to coat a sample on the IQ substrate, we can use this assembly that we prepared in our laboratory. That we have a UV curing chamber. You can see from here that a UV curing chamber, just to polarize the samples, we use this unit. So a fixed intensity of the UV lamp is fixed here, and we can follow the light of different at a different distance, so different intensity can be observed. These are the this is basically a DSO. Okay, so we can use the to get the waveform that are the outputs which come for the samples. So that can be measured from here. This is the function generator. We can apply the different pulses. This is the multimeter, and this is the another the high voltage amplifier just to magnify the voltage. This is the optical setup just to study the optical properties like transmission study. You can see from this side. So here we can do our electro-optical measurement. So we can apply the pulse to the sample, and sample will be placed again here, and the output will be recorded through this photo detector. This is a photo detector. So the photo detector which will be connected to the oscilloscope. So what are the pulse we have given to the sample, and we can see the output of the oscilloscope. So this is the another setup which we have. So last thing, if I am saying that how we can prepare the sample. So this is the place where we can prepare the samples. So such type of sample can be prepared here. We generally prepared our samples in our laboratory. So this is a little bit information about the preparation of the cell and the major experimental facility which we have in the laboratory.
Hello, this is the computer lab of the Department of Physics, and this lab is specifically for the MSc first year students. In this lab, we taught the students of MSc first year the numerical methods, and they implement those numerical methods in the machine using the Fortran programming language.
This is our whole lab, and we have different equipments over here, and you can see some of the equipments which are placed over here. We have this one dark room is on my right, and this is the another dark room that we have. We have equipments related to electricity and magnetism, semiconductor devices, thermodynamics, experiments like that. For example, this experiment is related to the study of magnetic field of solenoid, where what we do is we use this gauss meter to measure the magnetic field, and we change the magnetic field, and then we see that what is the profile of magnetic field when we move away from the center of the coil. We have different coils of different sizes, different shapes, not shapes but sizes. And for example, that there is another experiment of Lee's method, where we measure the thermal conductivity of a bad conductor. So the bad conductor is placed in between these plates, and then we heat the whole system using this steam, which we create in this particular setup. In this dark mode, right now it's not dark, we have few experiments related to photodiode and Newton's ring. So I'll just show you one of our experiment, which is the de Broglie equation, and I'll just give some details about that particular experiment. So this is our second dark room, and in this particular dark room you can see that we have experiment related to prism, and then we have experiment related to diffraction grating, and this is the de Broglie experiment that I will show you in a minute. So this is the setup that we use to measure the de Broglie equation. In this, what we do is that we are impinging energetic electrons on a crystal, and because this crystal acts like a diffraction grating, therefore it diffracts the electrons. The electron wave diffracts, and you can see the diffracted electron beam on this particular luminous screen, where you can see the rings that are forming due to this diffraction effect. So this is the power supply, and the electrons are being produced in the electron gun, which is over here, and in this is a sealed vacuum tube. The whole tube, the whole bulb is in vacuum, because we require electrons to travel from the electron gun to the screen. That is why we need to create the vacuum. And the diameter of the ring is related to the its de Broglie wavelength, and that is why we can calculate, or you can verify the de Broglie wavelength using this particular setup. Because we know how much voltage we are applying, we know what is the diameter, we can change the voltage from here, that will accordingly change the diameter, and you can get the relation between the two. This is the setup here. So what I am going to do now is I am going to reduce the accelerating voltage to zero. And you can see that the intensity of the luminosity that we are getting from this particular screen has gone to zero. And if I increase the voltage now slowly, then you can see that a central spot is coming there, which is actually the electron which is not getting diffracted at all. And when I increase the intensity, when I increase the voltage gradually, then you will see that these rings are appearing. And what we do now is that we measure the diameter of these rings using the vernier calipers that you can use. And as I said, this diameter of this particular ring is related to lambda, the de Broglie wavelength. And because these are non-relativistic electrons, therefore you can easily find the relation between lambda and the accelerating voltage. So in this way, indirectly you are getting the relation, or you are verifying the de Broglie wavelength by changing the voltage and observing the change in the diameter of these rings, and you can verify the de Broglie equation. For example, if I keep increasing the voltage, then you can see that this value of lambda will keep on decreasing. Okay, because when you are increasing the voltage, the kinetic energy is increasing, the value of lambda is decreasing, that is why this diameter is decreasing. So this is a qualitative explanation, and what students do is to verify the same equation quantitatively.
Apart from this, the department has also organized educational trips to various research institutions like RRCAT, UGC-DIE Consortium for Scientific Research, IIT Indore, and PU Chandigarh. The department is also actively involved in conducting various extracurricular activities like cultural fests, annual sports meets, quiz competitions, and cleanliness drives, which inculcates the moral and ethical values in the students with the sense of competitiveness. Our alumni are foreigners in several research laboratories and notable academicians with a significant contribution towards society. During their tenure in the department, the students are given life-defining experiences that enables them to reach new heights in their professional and personal lives.